Hey guys, what's up? I'm Noah, this is Analog Resurgence, and today we're going to take a look at a camera from my own collection, the Yashica LD6. So first of all, I do want to say that when I'm shooting Super 8, I'm not looking for anything really crazy. I want a camera that will just give me the basic kind of things I need and I can just kind of throw some batteries in it and use it and go. I see a lot of people trying to get into Super 8 and they immediately start looking at the higher end cameras like the Canon 1014 or the Nikon R10. And these are great cameras and they have a ton of features, but they also fetch a pretty high price on eBay in the used market. So you don't necessarily need one of those if you're just trying to get into the format and maybe want to have a camera that you can just pick up and go. This is the Yashica LD6. The Yashica LD6 opens from behind and inside it has 5 stairs to register a variety of ISO film types. Now the great thing about this camera is that it has a really reliable auto exposure feature, which means that it will meter anything between 25 ISO and 400 ISO according to the website Filmcorn, which gives you information on different cameras. For the test film that I shot in this camera, I used a discontinued cartridge of Kodak Plus X black and white reversa film. So this film was discontinued a number of years ago and is just something that I've had stored in a freezer. So it's reliable enough that I know I can still shoot it just to see if the camera is functioning properly. This is a medium speed black and white reversal film, and because it's reversal, it requires some decent exposure from the camera. I've actually had really poor results in a previous camera that I own using it on fully automatic functions. So if you look at this footage, you can see that it's just really blown out. There's very poor contrast. There's not a lot that I can kind of bring back even in a digital edit from it. And it doesn't really look that good even if I project it. But in comparison, if you put it through the Yashica here entirely on auto features, you can see immediately that it is a little more precise. Now you can see that it is still maybe just a little overexposed here and there, but not so much that I can't bring back some of that contrast in a digital edit of it from the transfer that I have. And it does look really good when I project it, which of course is what I want when I'm shooting reversal film. So the Yashica has a few frame rate options on the camera: 18 frames per second, 24 frames per second, and 36 frames per second. Now, of course, some cameras do have a wider variety of frame rate speed options on the camera, but this gives me what I want in a camera really, because I can shoot at 18 if I'm shooting at projection speed for reversal film that I want to see later, or I can shoot entirely in 24 and that will give me a better kind of smoother looking image once I have it digitally transferred, and it just will look a little bit better on that platform. And 36 frames gives me just like a little bit of slow motion for projection speed, because it's essentially double 18 frames and it will give me something fun to play around with. So here on the handle I actually have a single frame exposure option, which means that if I press the trigger down, it will only expose one frame, which means that I can really easily set it up with like a trigger release that you would usually use with other cameras, because it has a socket here, or potentially track down a time-lapse motor if Yashica ever made one for it, but I'm not too sure if they made ones for these models. Also in the handle of the camera is the battery compartment. So if I just screw off the handle that also has a tripod socket on the bottom, I can find the battery compartment and this pops open and actually takes 6 AA batteries. 6 AA batteries is quite a few batteries, but if I get some rechargeables, that's really good. And also the trade-off that is really appealing is that the camera only needs those batteries to run. A lot of cameras will require a secondary battery, an older, harder to find mercury battery, or an equivalent to that kind of battery to power the internal light meter, but this camera doesn't. It runs entirely off the 6 AA batteries found in the handle, and it has a nice little battery check button there. Press it down, I have the green light, which means it's good to go. I think one of the coolest features on the camera are these fade options, which is controlled by these two buttons here. So this is a knob here, and if you look at the test footage, I've done a test on it with the shot of the pumpkin, and you can see that the camera allows me to do some fade outs and some fade ins entirely in camera. Now, on top of that basic fade feature is another feature that only a handful of cameras actually have. And I don't have any other cameras that are capable of doing this, but it's a crossfade feature. The crossfade feature is controlled by this green slider on the camera here. So when I'm using it, all I have to do is push it to the side and it will double expose onto the beginning of the next roll by rewinding slightly into the cartridge. So really the only feature I can think of that this camera doesn't have that I wish it did is some more manual control for the light meter in case I'm in situations where I want to have a little bit more control. Now the camera does have an exposure compensation dial, which allows me to over or under expose the film just a little bit, but overall the system is still entirely automatic and I can't kind of lock off exposure for trickier situations where it might be trying to compensate when I don't want it to. But I do have some other cameras that have these manual options, so it is the trade-off that I'm willing to take. So overall, I'm really happy with the Yashica. It just gives me enough basic features that I can, you know, throw some batteries in it and pick it up and start using it right away. And is definitely the sort of camera that I would recommend to anybody who just wants something really basic or just want something that they can just start pick up and using and as easy as a first camera to use to get into the format. Yashica made a few great Super 8 cameras, and if you're looking for something that is easier to get into, is maybe not super expensive, then I would definitely recommend looking out for cameras like the LD6, the LD8, or the Super 600, because they can usually be found for cheaper prices as well. And they are pretty great cameras, so I would recommend checking those out. I'll put a link to some more information about those specific cameras in the description down below, so you guys can check those out if you're interested in maybe picking those up as your first cameras. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I really hope that you enjoyed, and subscribe for more analog content every week, because I'm gonna be covering a variety of formats, histories, cameras, and different things for you guys to check out and learn more so that you guys can get into these formats yourselves. Thank you guys so much, and I'll see you soon.